Hola a todos, yo soy Recuda Cayer, and welcome to the second Q&A video. We have a lot more questions this time around, so let's just jump right into it. Do you think you'll ever go pro with your music career, and what do you plan on doing after the MLP series ends? It depends on what you mean by going pro. If you define going pro as in getting signed onto a record label or something of that caliber, probably not. I don't really enjoy the idea of having a lot of my creative liberties taken away simply because of being signed onto a label, and they have a lot of boundaries and a lot of rules and a lot of expectations and deadlines and stuff as well that I think I'd rather just avoid for the most part. I don't really want to get too entangled in that because I work better just doing my own stuff in my own time. And as far as when the MLP series ends, I'm probably just going to keep making music like I have been. I don't think that the MLP series ending means that the fandom is ending, like a lot of people are trying to propagate. It's like the fandom's been around for, you know, the entirety of the season, or the entirety of the show. It's not just going to disappear just because the show ends. And even with Generation 4 ending, we've got Generation 5 on the horizon, and if that's even half as good as the current season, there's still going to be plenty of material to work with and create music for. So yeah, I just see myself making more music no matter, you know, even after the series ends. You like to travel? Some place you would like to visit? Yes, I actually really enjoy traveling. Even just simple things like going on car rides around the city or whatever, it's just being out and going, seeing the world is one of my favorite things to do. And as far as if there's some place I'd like to visit, I would say that I would really, I really want to visit either like someplace up like in Northern Europe, either Iceland or Scotland or Sweden or something like that, because I really enjoy the culture there and the history there, and just the scenery as well. I would love to see that with my own eyes one day. Will you ever re-upload your Sights and Scene videos, particularly Paradise? No. I'm not going to be re-uploading those videos to my channel at all. They're currently unlisted or privated, and they're going to stay that way because I just don't really want those videos on my channel. I took them down because I felt like they didn't meet the quality that I wanted to maintain at the time of their release. Obviously, if it was up to the standards of what I do now, everything would be gone. But just at the time of the release, you know, I unlisted a lot of videos that I felt like when I released them, they really weren't finished, or they really weren't complete, or I could have spent more time making them better. And videos like Paradise or Pegasus Factory definitely fall into those categories, and I just don't want them on my channel anymore. From the old songs, like since After the Afterlife, will there be any songs like those similar? I mean, like in the version of music and singing. Depends, really. I can't say for certain because my music style just evolves and changes as it does. I don't really force myself to make a specific genre or make a certain style or make my song sound a certain way. I just make music that I think sounds good, and if I want to do something, I do it. And that's why I tend to mash up a lot of genres together, because I just kind of just go with what I'm feeling at the time. So maybe at some point I might end up making a return to some of my older styles, but who's to say? I guess we'll see. Have you ever been to a convention? Do you have a job besides YouTube? And if so, then what do you do? I have been to a convention. I went to BernieCon 2016, and it was one of the best times that I've had, especially with traveling and seeing my friends and just being able to partake in the fandom, I guess, in a more physical sense as opposed to just the online version of it. And I do plan on going back to BronyCon this year as well in 2019 for the final one, so I really hope that that goes as well as the first one did, because I love going to the cons, not just BronyCon but any con. It's just a good time to be had. And do I have a job besides YouTube? Yes, I do. I work at Panera Bread. I'm an associate trainer, which basically means that I'm in charge of teaching people how to work. The new people that come through our store, especially since we're a manager training store, the new managers that come through and they have to learn how we do things, I'm one of the people that's in charge of teaching them and training them to be the best standard that we can. And I love my job, to be honest. It's a little stressful sometimes, but I don't really like want to quit it or anything. Do you work alone or in a group? I work alone, and I will work alone for the foreseeable future, because I don't really enjoy the idea of working in a group for similar reasons that I don't really want to get signed onto a label, as I mentioned earlier. I don't want my creative liberties to be taken away, because if you're working in a group, you can't just do whatever you want and then that's it. You have to consider what the other person wants to do as well, and sometimes that's good. That's why, like, sometimes collabs are fun and everything, because you get some new ideas, but doing it for every single song that we release, I wouldn't. That just sounds really annoying and something I don't want to deal with. So I just work solo. Always have, always will. What's your favorite genre of music? What's your favorite song or songs of all time? Where do you do your recording for your songs? So my favorite genre of music, even though I'm not really like super keen on what exactly differentiates the genres and everything, my favorite genre is trance by far. I feel like it does exactly what the name would imply it does, and it really calms me. Most trance music just really calms me. Doesn't really matter like what kind of trance it is, and I just really, really enjoy how it sounds. I find it very relaxing. I find it very like kind of like cinematic almost in a electronic way. It just, you know, it's good to listen to. But my favorite song or songs of all time, it's kind of hard to pick between them because I listen to so much music, but I would say that if I could pick my top three favorite songs, at least currently, or, you know, around this time, it would be Paralyzed by NF. I'm paralyzed. Where are my feelings? I no longer feel things. I know I should. Lost by Eden. Or I Will Fail You by Demon Hunter. I feel like these three songs, usually when I really enjoy songs because I can relate to it or it really captures my emotions, and I feel like these songs definitely hit that right on the mark. But where do you do your recording for your songs? I record all of my songs right here in my living room, because, you know, I live in an apartment, so my, like, it's basically just like the living room, dining room area, the kitchen, the bedroom, the bathroom. So right here in my living room area, just record the songs right here. I don't really have any sound pads or anything around or any kind of super professional equipment. I do have my microphone, which has a little like a pad thing over it. I do have a pop filter, but I don't need to really use it that often because I have this thing over my microphone, which helps get rid of the p sounds. But yeah, pretty simple, you know, not very complicated as far as recording music goes. Alright, and that's the end of this Q&A video, the second one for this channel. Thank you to everyone who gave out these questions, and I hope that you really enjoyed watching. If you have any questions that you would like answered in a future Q&A, just leave them down below and I will absolutely get to them. And yeah, thank you everyone for watching. I hope you all have a wonderful day. Bye!